Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to set up CoolProp plugin in Microsoft Excel. In my opinion, among the free fluid properties library available in public domain, CoolProp is the closest alternative to RefProp. The margin of error in CoolProp is within acceptable range. So why CoolProp? CoolProp is free and an open source thermophysical properties database for several fluids that can be installed in several applications and programming languages such as MATLAB, Python, Fortran, LabVIEW, and many more depending on what you are using. So if you're interested in using CoolProp in MATLAB, you can follow the link below this video on how to set up CoolProp in MATLAB. With CoolProp plugin installed in your Excel, you can now access hundreds of fluid properties library. Let's jump into this straight away. To begin, I will open my browser and go to type in CoolProp and go to CoolProp download. And once you have CoolProp download, I will go to the files pivot. And I have my CoolProp folder here. So you see within the CoolProp folder, you have the last modified CoolProp is in August, which is the latest version. So I click on this folder. And again, you have a list of all the versions of CoolProp. So my interest will be the recent version. So in case you're watching the video, just go to the most recent version of CoolProp. In my case, this is 6.4.1. So depending on when you're watching the video, it could change, but this is the latest version as at the time of this video. So I click on the folder, and quickly, there are two ways to install CoolProp into your computer and to your Microsoft Excel. The first method is an automated process, which is easy. All you need to do is you go to the installer here and you click on Windows. You see this folder, you click on Windows folder, and then you click on the CoolProp executable file. And once you click on it, it begins to download. It prompts you and it begins to download. Once the download is complete, you go to wherever you've saved this file. Go to my download folder here, and this is the CoolProp that has finished downloading. I can double click on it now and install it. Next. And finish. And you see with this method, automatically there will be a text Excel file that would appear on your desktop. And this is again the sample ES file. So with this now, I can now open this Excel file. So immediately this is open, I can now check if the add-in was properly installed in the Microsoft Excel. To do that, I go to my file pivot and click on options, and in the options I click on add-ins to check if it's there. So you can see the CoolProp add-in has been included. That's why I like the automated process. It does this automatically for you without having to add any manual input. So the next thing to do is to copy down this location you have here. Make sure you copy it down. And then you take whatever you've copied here to Trust Center. You click on Trust Center, and then you go to Trust Center settings, and then you come to add new location. So in your case, once you open up this environment, you wouldn't find this location in your environment. So you need to add that location in there. So to add that location, you come to add location, and then you paste whatever you've copied into this place, and then that's the way you save that location there. So I'm going to cancel it because I already have that in here. And then I click on close, I click on OK, and maybe I can now open a new Excel file so I can now show you how to check the fluid properties now. So I can type in here, let's say temperature, and I can type in here, say pressure, and then I could type in my CP, I can type in my enthalpy. And then I could give a particular temperature of interest, 288.15. And then maybe I could say pressure of 1. And then for the CP, I could say equals, and then I can put at, and I put prop. So you go down this list, you see this phase is part of the adding for that. So I'm interested in this one, prop C. So I will select prop C, and once I have that, I can now enter. Remember, you need to put your double quotation sign for the CP. So C is representing the CP. You put a comma, take this off, and then you put the temperature range you are interested in, and then you select the value. And then you put the pressure, and then you select the value, comma, and then you enter your fluid, let's say nitrogen, and then I close it, and you see that's my fluid property. I could do the same for enthalpy. Say equals at prop C. So that's the one I'm interested here. I'm interested in. I do the same thing rather than C now, I do for H, which is for enthalpy. And the T. Sorry, I need to end the. Sorry, cancel. I need to add the quotation sign, double quotation sign. Yeah. So that's my T. And then I did the same for P, the pressure. Select the pressure. Sorry, I missed something there. So I put a comma sign. And then I select the value for the pressure. This is the value for my pressure. And then again, I select the fluid I'm interested in. And that's it. So you see you have the CP value, you have the enthalpy value. So I could do this for any fluid. I could do this for, let's say I want to do it for, let's come here, I want to do this for helium. I could also enter the fluid property. The fluid that I'm interested in, helium. And that's it, it gives me the value for helium. So with this, you can select any fluid that you are interested in. So the second method, I will just show you quickly. I'm not a fan of the second method because it's a bit complicated to use that method, but I'm gonna show you quickly. I will close this, don't save, I'll close this. And then the second method, you go back to your browser where you have your CoolProp, come to File, and then you come to CoolProp folder. And when you have the CoolProp folder, you come to the most recent folder. And then you go to Microsoft Excel. Then this is, you need to download all this files that you have here. So this one is if you have your Excel before 2007, then you can use this one. If your Excel is after 2007, then you need to download this one. Again, you can download the Excel file, Excel test file. So once you download this, and it's gonna prompt you, and then it will start downloading. And then once that is downloaded, it doesn't end there. You also need to go back again, download this one. And once you download this one, you go back again to your folder and you come to this environment and go to shared library, download, open the shared library, and then you see Windows. You open Windows and then you need to select the DL file. So this DL could be 32 bits depending on your computer, or 64 bits. So you have to download it. And then you download the CoolProp DLL. So once you download this, it's a bit of a complicated process. I don't like that process. I would rather prefer the first one, which is automated. And once this is completed, the next thing you need to do is to go to your Excel environment, and quickly, once your Excel is open, you go to File, then you come to Option, and then you go to Add-in, and then in my case, I use the first method, so that's why you have your Add-in here. So if you don't have your Add-in, you need to go to Go. Here you have your Manage Excel Add-in. You go to Go, click on Go. And then here you wouldn't have it here because mine is already installed. So you go to Browse, and wherever you have your CoolProp Excel file located on your system, see it default. In my case, this is it here. You click on it and you open. And once that is installed on your add-in, the next thing you need to do, you need to make sure that you have the DL, wherever you have the DL saved, the DL that you downloaded, you have it saved. Again, you go back to your Trust Center. Your option here, go to Trust Center, go to Trust Center setting, and locate wherever you have. You go to Trust Center location here, and then find wherever you have the DL file located, and to make sure that the Excel can access that part. And with that, then you can be able to run any fluid property in Excel. So I'm not a fan of the second method. I prefer the first method, like I showed you. And that's how you can install Excel plugin in your computer. I hope you find this video useful and you now know how to set up CoolProp in your Microsoft Excel environment. If you did find this video useful, please click the like button and subscribe, and as well hit the notification button so you can be notified when we do our next video. Thank you for watching and see you in my next video. Bye for now.